Hello, everybody. Today, I have so much to tell you that it really does matter. It might matter, it might not. If you don't know me, first of all, let me allow me to introduce myself. My name is Michelle. I'm a mom of 12 amazing kids. I have 9 boys, 3 girls, and number 13 on the way. And as you know, if you've been watching and following along, she has been giving me a run for my money, and I have no idea what she's got up her sleeve. Hi, Brandy. Good to see you. So today, what I would like to do is give you a rundown, Fran Apple, hi, and let you know 10 random facts about this mom-to-be of baby 13. Hi, Aaron. Hi, Zach. Thanks for being here, everybody. I can't wait to share with you these little tips, or not really tips, but just little tidbits. That's the word, tidbits, about me, this mom of 12, wanting to have baby 13. So, these are things about labor that I know today, me, having a lot of kids before, but this is what I know. Number one, I get asked about the most, and I will tell you right now, there is no baby yet. Nope, she hasn't come. Nope, she hasn't arrived. Nope, she's playing tricks on me. That's the way it goes. Number two, do I have random contractions? Yes. Do I start out in the morning thinking she's coming? Yes. Do I have signs and symptoms that make me think she's coming? Yes. And she tricks me every day. This girl is sneaky. Could the weather have something to do it? I think absolutely yes. We have so much precipitation. We have rain. We have snow. We have, you know, just that barometric pressure on me at this time is outrageous. You know, when you've got snow in mountains that you normally don't have snow in, you have rain, you have the clouds everywhere, it puts that pressure on my belly, making me think that it's time. And then I find out it's not. There's another day. Number four, I'm glad that she's in there and that she's cozy and comfy and she's not ready to leave, because that just means her cheeks are getting fat and she's getting that good layer of fat. Her brain is developing further, which definitely could be a positive for her. So we want her to stay in as long as possible, because earlier on in the pregnancy, they told me there was a part of her brain that wasn't quite properly developed. So maybe that extra time in here can actually help her with that. Like I said, we're praying for miracles, right? Well, some of those miracles might mean that she has to stay inside so that she could actually grow. Which brings us to number five. No, she has not been born yet. No, I'm not in labor. No, the baby's not here. But hey, it's tip number five. Number six. Just so you know, when I do have the baby, I will not be quiet about it. Everyone will know. I'll post it on Instagram. I'll post it on Facebook, on all three of my Facebook groups. Got Kids, Keep It Real, Mom Support, and Keep It Simple. And then on my personal page, Michelle Taylor. So you will see somewhere. Not to mention YouTube. You guys will probably know first, because I'll just say it out loud and record it. And I'll be so excited to share with you. You won't miss out. I won't let you. I mean, that'll be like within the first hour. And I don't care if I look crazy, if I don't have makeup on, whatever. I will tell you like it is, because you know me, I'm transparent. I want you to know everything as it is and for real. Does that mean that I'm having a hard time? Absolutely. I'm having a hard time because I want her to be here, yet I'm having mixed feelings and know that she's better off in there. But yet I get excited because she's coming, and then she plays a trick on me. And I'm just like, what do I do? So I keep trying to stay busy. I do my routines. They keep me sane. I go ahead and do school with the kids every day. That helps me out. Taking a day off just means they're just running around playing and doing electronics and thinking it's summertime, which it is not. They've just got a little bit more school too. I think we're going to be ahead of time, and we'll probably be done a month ahead. Just wanted to throw that in. Pretty excited about that. Number seven, one bad thing about having a home birth is you really don't know when the baby's coming. If you have a hospital birth and you schedule the date, you're most likely gonna have the baby that day or the following day. There's not gonna be a whole lot of play in the day. You know it's coming right away. But when you're having a home birth, you have no idea when that's gonna happen. That's gonna take a role any place anytime. It could happen in the wee morning hours. It could happen in the middle of the night. It could happen in the middle of the afternoon. It could happen right now. It could happen in 30 minutes. You just don't know. And that's okay, because sometimes women opt to have a natural, want their body to just go into labor naturally. And so even in the hospital, you know, they might think, my scheduled induction date is 2 weeks from now, so I'm going to get all these projects done. I have a friend who did that. She's walking around Home Depot and bam, her water breaks 2 weeks prior to her induction date. So that would put it in a funny spot, right? That you wouldn't be expecting that. It would be, surprise, I'm coming. I don't have that problem, obviously, because there are only, that brings us to fact number eight for the labor and delivery, is that I have 5 days until my 40 weeks. So on Monday, I will be 40 weeks pregnant. I am 39 weeks and 3 days right now. So that puts me really close to the full term, right? You're already full term at 39 weeks. You're fine at 38 weeks to have a baby, but even more full term considered at 39 weeks, and done at 40. And my babies, like I said, do tend to go over a week or two. Wouldn't that be insane? That would be totally bonkers. I don't even know if it's possible, but who knows? Anything's possible at this point after seeing what I've seen this little girl pull. She's a funny one. Fact number nine. What am I craving? Am I having cravings? Absolutely. I have been craving soft foods, things that are easy to digest, because I am so afraid of puking. Because sometimes you do that. If the baby drops really hard fast, or you go into labor really fast, that you will puke up whatever's in your stomach. And I want it to taste not so gross, you know? The toilets are clean. Every time I walk by a toilet, I swab it because I don't want it to be gross inside. I wipe the rim. I get it all cleaned up, because if I have to heave over that threshold, that, you know, what do they call that? The throne right there. I want to make sure that it's clean and that I won't puke more because of it, right? So I'm eating things like soup. I'm eating a lot of ice cream big time. Love that Breyers all natural ice cream. They have that natural strawberry, that natural butter, well, mostly natural butter pecan, and I just love that, because I know that if I'm going to throw up my last meal, it's going to taste better if it has some ice cream on top. So I learned that with my first baby, and I never forgot it, because with her, I puked all 9 months. I didn't know the tricks of the trade that I know now. It was a nightmare. And number 10, the baby is still not here yet. In case you didn't catch that with number one and number five, number 10, she's still not here yet. Go figure. What a toad, right? So yeah, I just wanted to throw those in there for you. I wanted you to know. So that's where I'm at. So I am going to go ahead and fall back on these comments. I said hello to almost everyone. Erin Dawn's here, and she said, girl, I'm praying for you. You got a stubborn little girl already. She's going to be sassy. Well, I don't really know if she's stubborn, if that her mom is just really overexcited, because she gave me a false alarm, but she's not really ready to come. She's like, get off me. I was just getting ready. I was upside down, meaning breech, for the first half of your pregnancy. I finally just got head down. Let me get settled, get where I need to be. Right? That is a possibility. And she's just like, no, don't push me out of here. I'm not ready to go. So she's still just hanging out and enjoying herself. And then she's going to be sassy. Now that's probably a definite thing. Joanne is here. Hi, Joanne. And then Molly's here. And good luck. Charlie asked a question. I'm trying to remember what it was, because it wasn't inappropriate. There we go. What food should a pregnant woman avoid? Good luck, Charlie. Whatever makes her have heartburn. I think if you get heartburn, just grab some of that papaya I've showed before. Take 4 or 5 tablets of that, and it will be gone. But anything that you see, like breads especially, bring up a lot of heartburn. So I really try to avoid bread. Although today I was craving a cinnamon roll and I ate one, which is not like me. And do I have heartburn? Yes, I'm ready to go take some papaya. So there you go. It's not necessarily that you should avoid so much as Just be careful what makes you sick. I mean, there are some things that they say don't eat, but like I still eat albacore tuna fish. I only crave it once or twice a month. So what the heck? I'm not going to be in trouble from that. So you just have to eat smart, you know, especially with seafood. The other thing is that Gretchen coming in at number 8. I'm not 100% sure what you meant by that unless you think you were on number 8. And then, as you know, you will not be pregnant forever. She will come when she's ready. That is right, Gretchen. I do know this. That is a fact I do know. But, you know, what's hard, what's difficult for me is I am a planner. I like to get things done. A pregnant belly definitely slows me down because you can only move so fast and get so much done. And you get tired, blah, blah, blah. But, I have a plan and I want to follow that plan. And I just know I'm trying to keep my plan simple right now because she's going to interrupt them like she should. And she may or she may not interrupt it on a good time or a bad time. And that's okay. Her prerogative. I just am saying it's not like I can plan to go take my kids to an eye doctor appointment or, you know, the boys had their orthodontist appointment today. And I didn't take them because I let my husband do that. And I guess that's okay. So I could take a wonderful nap. That's why I didn't get on earlier. But hey, you never know. It's just a fact of life that she's not here yet. It's a fact of life that I have no idea when she's coming. I will barely have any notice, I am sure. That's how she's been doing it so far. And most of my kids have done it. I usually get a 3-hour window. I know about 3 hours in advance, and that's about it. Some of them only give me an hour's notice, so you never know. That's where I am. Do you have any questions or comments that you'd like to share now? If so, go ahead and throw those down, and I will answer them to the best of my ability. And if not, I'll just say sayonara and go take care of the family who just got back home from those appointments. So there we go. Like even right now I'm having a good contraction, but it's not doing enough. I've been having them all day off and on and I'm not dilating. So what does it matter? It's just life and the weather and how close we are. I mean, only 5 days away from 40 weeks pregnant. Can you believe that? 5 days away. After all this time, we've made it. Ashley Beauty, hello, how are you? I was thinking about this. I'm like, what videos can I watch? And I heard you had a really good lipstick and eye makeup video that came out recently. So I was like, I want to go check her out so I can see that video. I bet it could help. Oh, thanks, Joanna. I really appreciate that. You're so sweet. Yeah, everybody's been... Oh my goodness, 2 a.m. and you can't sleep. Good heavens, Ashley. But yeah, I've got everybody texting me, messaging me privately on Facebook, publicly messaging me on Facebook. I've got people who are Marco Poloing me, people calling me, people who are bombarding my YouTube channel. And I'm like, it's okay. I don't mind, but I can't answer everybody. So I'll just do one big announcement. She's not here. I will let you know. Oh, that's a good idea. We should do karaoke. Oh my gosh. I thought about playing for you today. I was going to record it. I was playing, I uploaded the Dirty Dancing album on my phone because I love the variety of music that it has on it. I love the flow of it and it gets me moving, whether I want to clean the bathroom or I just want to sit, I want to make the bed or whatever chores I'm doing. But it really is good when you're on the yoga ball, you know, because that first one, yes, everyone asking when, for sure. But here I am blabbing it all on YouTube, so somebody's going to find out eventually. I've got family and friends on here, and who knows who else. But I was doing, you know, that one, I'll needed you so, that one. So I'm all on the yoga ball, and I'm dancing around, and I'm moving around and bouncing. I'm like, I should do a YouTube on how to do the yoga ball when you're pregnant. And then I stood up to watch to see if I looked hideous when I'm standing up dancing. I'm like, yeah, I could probably do it, but I don't know how to record it and at the same time listen, except for if I do it on my computer. So we could totally do that. You want to watch a pregnant woman dance her socks off? I can do 15 minutes of karaoke and probably not go into labor. That would be hilarious, wouldn't it? Because I've heard that that could actually make you go into labor, and that would be really funny if my water broke. So if everybody says, do it, maybe I will, because I guess I could fall to peer pressure sometimes. Hi, Monique. It's so glad to see you. Let's see. I'm glad I made you laugh, Ashley. Yes, everyone. Let's see. Did you give birth next week on Monday or Wednesday? Since you're going to be 40. Yeah, I have no idea when I'm going to give birth. Good luck, Charlie. I just said that. Hi, Michelle. Yay, good to catch you live. It's a great day when I get to go live with my favorite women on YouTube. I agree, Monique. That's awesome. I love seeing you guys always on Cats. That's so fun. And then, it reminds you of your husband, or reminds your husband of his ex, so he doesn't get to listen to it. But I do, right? Because I don't know about your husband's ex. I also downloaded another one. I can't remember which one, but I thought about downloading the Top Gun one because it's got some hot songs on it too. I just like the Dirty Dancing one because it has some older ones. But you know what else does is Ferris Bueller's Day Off. That one has some. Hi, Mel. Let's see. Yeah, let's see. Meowly. That's Molly. And Sunshine Baby, hi. You missed it, but I'll tell you again. No baby yet. No baby news. You're one of the ones that asked me on YouTube. Nope, no baby. Just some contractions, but nothing that's doing enough to make me have a baby. So she might not come till next week. In 5 days, I'll be 40 weeks pregnant. So you'll see how it really goes. It's kind of funny because if I didn't have any idea that she was Down syndrome, I'm going to pull up this just in case I get crazy. If I had, I am a little bit stressed just because I'm like a planner and I really want to know what's going on, but not bad enough to schedule a date and go get induced. Does that make sense? I've already tried that and that way is no bueno for me. But, I don't remember what else I said. It made it funny. Let's see who else. Sending love and prayers. 40, thank you, Sunshine Baby. Fran Apple, 47-year-old beauty, gives birth to 13th child while dancing on a yoga ball. Wouldn't that be the bomb? The unknown scares me so much, I can't imagine not knowing, like you said, exactly. And then, I think you have to get to where... So if I play it, Joanna, would you be mad? Because your husband's not watching me, right? I know he's my friend on Facebook, but I don't think that he's going to hear this. So tell me, Joanna, I'm waiting on you. If you say it's okay, I can play it. I will. And then we'll go from there. No, play away. Yay, Joanna gives the okay. Because that would make me really sad if I messed up on that. So let me find that first song. Because it was so funny. This is the one. And I don't know, maybe it'll do a commercial or not. But this is the Dirty Dancing. I should have turned on the sound for a second. I'm not very good at this stuff. I am not Mr. B, and I don't know how to do it all, but I am willing to try. And Kat is going to die when she sees this. All right, so I can't get rid of this, but I can skip it. Hallelujah. So I'll give all the credit to Time of My Life, and I'll just let you laugh your heads off. Here we go. That is so funny. I can't believe I'm going to do this. Okay. Just want to make sure the volume is up good. Otherwise, it's not as fun. Okay, you ready? Here we go. And then I'll just get my yoga stretching on. I'll just make it to where I can get my, how I like to stress. Because when you're pregnant, the more movement you do in your hips, it just really helps loosen things up, whether or not you are actually going to be in labor or not. So it's just kind of a good beat, you know? And then you get your belly bumping. You can all sing karaoke. That's funny. I would show you on my ball, but I'm thinking it would be too hard. Yeah, it would be too hard to do it. You can see my yoga ball right there. See it in the background? It's there waiting for me all the time. But when I'm on my yoga ball, I'm down and I'm just rotating my hips, and that feels amazing. You can't believe how good it is on your bump. I'm gonna turn this down just a little bit. Sorry if it's too loud. Is it too loud or does it sound good? So this is how a pregnant lady dances. And I always stop my husband and make him dance with me, because it feels good to hold someone. Sorry you can't see more. I don't know how to do it better. Definitely will help pass the time, right? And you can see the belly bump from the side. Yeah, exactly. The little one will have a good time. I do. I probably have way too much energy. We're doing a little bit of karaoke. Except I'm not singing too much with a microphone. So here comes my husband. I just told him that you dance with me sometimes. Oh my gosh. He just timed it right and just came in. I'm just showing him my yoga stretches that I do on the yoga ball. I know, that's the point. I don't mind if you can see my face or not. Yes. I could, but they won't be able to see it.
Oh, okay.
Because I can't put it up high. And it's just on my face. And Ashley Beauty's on here. She's up at 2 a.m. in Australia. Oh, no, in yeah, I think that's true. And she is up at 2 a.m. She can't sleep.
Wow.
And she's saying you got so much energy, and that's an understatement. Can you imagine how hard it is for me to slow down? Yeah, he's a good one. Yeah, I'll just test a little bit. You're sweet to dance with my big belly. You like my belly? Because you're nice. See, he's just the right amount of tall for me. And that's enough belly dancing. That is true belly dancing, right? That's true belly dancing with the husband. That's what I should do, is I should do dancing until I go into labor. Exactly. The only problem is with karaoke and a pregnant woman is that I'll probably have to go potty, and then you'll just have to wait for me while I go potty. And that would be ridiculous. Unless I had my husband dance for you while I was going potty. That would be fun. He said that ain't gonna happen. I was lucky to get him on for that dance. He was inspired by that song. Yeah, I hope she... do my children watch me? Yes, they know how silly I am. They don't come in when I'm doing a video because they know it distracts me, and then I start talking to them and I forget about the phone because I'm a pretty good mom that way. And I have to shoo them out, but sometimes it's more, it's easier said than done. Yes, my husband is so sweet. Thanks, Joanna. I'm so excited you got to hear that song. Be right back. That's fine. And then, yes, she's still baking. You can see that, Lorena. Thanks for jumping on. It's good to see you. I'm so glad you love that. The belly of the ball, right? That's good. So what else can we do to keep this time going so that we're not just sitting around, you know? I need to fill out the baby book, but again, that's sitting down and doing something very quietly. And you could tell by my energy, I don't sit down a lot. So it's kind of hilarious. Oh, well, girls, I hope you had a good time. Maybe I'll do it again. I don't know. I can't decide. I'll have to see how that goes, and then wouldn't that be funny if that's all it was? I see some of these other pregnant women doing these YouTube videos, and I'm just like, what the heavens? And they're just crazy, and I don't know that I dance like them. I just let the music move me. It feels better that way, right? But now you know the 10 random facts that there's no baby yet, and she's 40 weeks and 5 days, so... You know what? My husband and I would love to do a Q&A. I've just never even asked him. But he's like, he likes watching the YouTube, so he's getting to know people on here. And Baby Mama. Baby Mama song, do I know that song? Oh, the one on Dirty Dancing? Yeah, that's the one, that was the second song on the dance list. And I was, yeah, right? The thing is, my babies don't come that way. Do you realize when I had baby number 4, we thought I was due a little later. My due date was off. We drove clear to Oklahoma because I'm from Oklahoma and that's where our family reunion was. And we were living in Utah at the time. And we drove all the way to Oklahoma and had this great family reunion. I had this cute pregnant belly. I'll have to post a picture for me sometime. And we danced like crazy. There was a big dance party on Friday night, and we all were dancing. I danced the whole night away. Didn't do anything. Nothing. I didn't have a baby in Oklahoma. We drove all the way home, and about 3 days later, like, I don't remember what day of the week it was, that baby was born. That's when we figured out the date was wrong, and he was full term, 8 pounds, 8 ounces. So, there you go. So, let's see. I'm looking for that baby song. It's hard because on my phone it's just ready to go, but on here it's not. So is this the one you mean? I think this is the song you mean. You'll have to tell me if it is because I can't see thumbs up right now. I think this is the right one. I think it is. Let's see. You tell me if I have it right or wrong.
Lincoln Nautilus uses a camera to scan the road ahead.
This is too funny. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm doing this. Talk about impromptu. Yes, this is the one, I think. Do you remember this movie? It's so great. This is my dance space. This is your dance space.
Don't look down.
Don't look down. And hopefully it's loud enough. I think the only bad thing is that you won't hear this one good. So if I can't hear it good, I can't dance good. You need it actually. I think it's crazy. Hey, baby. Here we go. This one. See, that's just getting me going. If I had my yoga ball, yeah. Good, you can watch this dance. You're the one who suggested it, Ashley. Because we can do just the one. You're perfect timing. Hey.
you'll be my girl.
Let's see what's back there, my rock.
When I saw you walking down the street, I said,
my husband, he's probably got a bookcase we can't move, right?
She's so pretty, Lord, she's fine. I'm gonna make her mine.
We have to do my dance like a ball.
Oh,
so we can be in trouble.
I wanna know if you'll be my girl.
Dance party with the Taylors, right? If the whole family was here, oh my gosh, ridiculous.
That's the way I wanna say. Come on, baby, give me your word. I wanna know if you'll be my girl.
Okay, that was fun. Thank you. Now he's running away.
Hey, so I watched Cat and Mr. B's Q&A today. It was kind of cool.
Oh, good. I didn't get to see that. Yeah, yeah, right? How'd you like that, Chelsea? The baby mama song? I think that's the one you meant. If not, I messed that totally up. Yeah, we thought about doing a Q&A, like after the Dr. Phil thing. We thought about doing a Q&A about the baby. Whatever, Ashley. You sound like you have a ton of energy whenever we're online. You're so funny. I'm like, you must have a ton of energy. With as many videos as you make, I don't even slow down enough to make videos. I like have to take a 15-minute break when I'm exhausted so I can sit here and visit with y'all. Because that's the only way it works. But, yeah. Let's see. I might do one more. That's about it. Because then I have to go potty. That's just the way it goes. I agree. That's why I quit doing those. I had a lot of editing videos where I would take clips from me talking, doing things around my house and all of that. And it was taking about, it only take me maybe a half hour to an hour to videotape, but then it would take 3 hours to edit it and they weren't even that good. So I just said, I'm either gonna have to be able to do it this way or not at all. And once in a while I could collect enough and put one together, but it still takes a little bit of time. And like if somebody wants to come and record me and do all that, then I like it for that reason too, but I have a family and they won't let me do that all the time. I'm like, I have to choose between my kids and doing a video. I guess I better choose the kids. Right? You do the photography and editing for me most of the time is consuming as well. Exactly. I did photography on the side and it reminds me a lot of that. That just takes too much time. And that's like what I said, you know, if there was ever an opportunity where someone was going to video, I would love to do a video or a show where someone was doing it for me so that they could see how a well-oiled ship runs and even the good and the bad that goes on with a family this size, but how much fun we have so it could promote big families and promote having children. But I don't know if there's room for that anymore. They've already had enough of the Duggars and these other crazy people that have a lot of kids. And I can't say that that's really what I want, you know? So, meaning for them. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, is the family would be in the video. It wouldn't just be me. Yeah, vlogs take for, that's what I'm talking about. Those vlogs take forever. That is just a little too much. So there you go. That's where I'm at. And I've only been YouTubing for, like, I think I've had an account since 2013, because I thought about doing it back then, but I never started until just over a year ago. And then I thought, why not? Now is better than never. So then I thought, you know, after having the twins, that maybe it's a good idea so that my kids could see videos and stuff when they grow up, but then I can make friends, because it's kind of lonely, me and a mom. You don't always have a lot of time to go out and be with friends. So it's really, it's been amazing getting to know so many people on YouTube that are across the country and even nearby that you would never, ever know so much about or even know at all. But YouTube makes it possible to have those friendships. And when we have these open dialogues, it's just so incredible the connections that happen, because there's so many people that are on my YouTube that I've never even met before that I would be totally comfortable going and visiting with. And I think that's the coolest thing about YouTube. So, see if I missed anything. I think I caught all that. I think, yes, YouTube is fab. And, exactly, that's how I feel. In fact, I was watching Kimmy in her apron. Actually, I was on a Facebook page. Yes, Joanna, I would come see you anytime, and I would love to go to a concert with you. But when I was on a Facebook page, a decluttering one, because it was just motivating to see other people decluttering, and then it inspired me to declutter more. And someone posted a video of Fly Lady Cat with, of Kimmy in her apron with Fly Lady Cat doing the desk, her office cleanup. And I was like, who is this person? I have to watch her. And so I heard he'd subscribed to her page, and I was just watching her and help, you know, learning from her. And I was just crazy about her. And then she had a spot open, and I was first to grab it for, I couldn't believe it. And she became my mentor. She's been my mentor for about a year now. So we're really close. And I just call her my mama cat, because she's kind of just that kind of a role for everyone, you know, and I just love that about her. So it's kind of fun. So I'm so glad we're friends, Joanna. Yeah, Southern Louisiana. I would love to go to Louisiana. That'd be awesome. That'd be great. So anyways, we've been on here forever, girls. I hope we wore you out, Ashley. And that you'll have amazing dreams after watching. You got to slow that brain down. You should try that app. I have it on my phone. It has a little raindrop. It's called Rain or just Rain. And it is so amazing. You can put whatever thunderstorm or rainstorm or noises that you want. It's a free app. And I listen to that at night. As soon as I play that, I have this thunderstorm, nature storm mix. And if I click both of those on with thunder cracks, I'm going to be asleep in 5 minutes or less, and I'm going to have it play for 45 minutes just in case I wake up for some reason, because sometimes you take that 15-minute nap and then all of a sudden you wake up, and I don't want that to happen. So I definitely am going to run that app for 45 minutes, and it's fantabulous. So try that. You're standing in the kitchen having a snack. Perfect. Oh, Joanna, love that. Charlie's... Yes, exactly. Okay, so did I miss anything else? Yeah, we all feel that way about her. Yeah, that's so awesome, Erin. We all adore her. She's the bomb. And she just makes it to where it just makes sense, and she simplifies it. I tried that Fly Lady stuff years and years and years ago, and it helped me for a long time. But then they started sending all these emails, and I thought I had to jump through all these hoops, and I was just like, done. I'll just keep doing the crisis cleaning every week and the home blessing hour every week and do chores every day, and hopefully it works, because that's what my mom did. But then clutter piles got away from me, and laundry got away from me, and dishes got away from me, and it just wasn't working, so I had to change things up. So, yeah, exactly. Actually, I'm not 100%. You're talking to me, Joanna. All right. Well, ladies, It's been a great night. We've had a good party. Sorry I'm not as entertaining. I think probably because it's impromptu. Maybe if I thought about it and had my lineup ready to go and didn't feel like I was so lost trying to find stuff because I've never done that before, then maybe it wouldn't have been so bad. But with my kids, we could totally do that. We just might. We might do a karaoke and you can get to know the Taylors because we've got some good dancers and they have the most hilarious personalities. I just am in love and I adore my children because they're just nuts. That's what Kat said, Ashley. She said on Friday, tomorrow is a new day, a fresh day, a wonderful day. Have a good night. It was so good to be here with all of you. Thank you so much for being here. And oh, you've been having migraines. No, you need to get that piercing, right? I've heard about that and that would be so great. Oh, yeah, that's what she guessed was this Friday. She keeps telling me that. She texts me that too. And I'm just like, stop it. I don't want to feel any pressure. I don't know when she's coming. But if she comes on Friday, great. And if she doesn't, oh well. So yeah, that's my final countdown. No baby yet. And I'm 40 weeks on Monday. So I'll give you an update then too. But I'll be here tomorrow and we'll see you then. Take care, ladies. Have a great night. We'll see you soon. It is hilarious, Ashley. Good night. Bye.